to go. They're under starters' orders. Lots of loud noises. A great start there for number 7. That is Kyle Vollmer. One rider not getting away so good, but we can see his hole shot. And oh, there's a bit of argy-bargy there. One rider's going over there. Oh, one rider went off the track and down. So back to turn one. There we can see the rider there.
It's just a gaggle. There's nowhere to go. Hooks a slide. Almost like he touched something yeah. wet there. And that was it. Game over.
That bike hit the floor hard, so I'm not surprised something broke. It might have been. It's either a radiator or a casing. Something went down, so we don't know what fluid that is.
Superbike magazine going and putting together a series like this, which is not easy. I mean, so I've got to ask, what made you guys decide, let's pull the motorbikes that we usually see racing around on dirt, slap some road tires on them, pull them into a series, and make it one of the most exciting South Africans. This is it. Lights on, lights off, and away they go. Mike Grove going and lifting his front. Lungu taking the opportunity, saying thank you very much for the wheelie, buddy, and dives up in second place. Mike Grove looking to go on the inside through T1, loses out, but Lungu Gweka immediately on the attack of Luca. Luca now having...
said he should do. I don't know if he was stuck in neutral or something, but he just didn't move, and I don't know how all the riders
want the person to move.
Yeah.
Okay, you can see everyone all lined up.
Well, here's the thing, the medics don't want them to move. It doesn't mean they listen. I know this from experience.
You know, I'm a...
third time.
Definitely not what we don't like seeing is guys getting hurt, but a big thank you to our medical crew who are fast and efficient, along with our marshals, to ensure that they're okay. And
our venture faller going off at the end over there. Yeah, so he's got to free. So you push the starter button, then you realize you've got to pull in the clutch, then it says you have to be in neutral, and then you curse every single Austrian alive, and finally the bike gets going again. I can talk about, I've raced for 26 years, so I had my experience of lying next to the track. And as you say, you know, the riders don't want to listen. All the rider cares about, I mean, we don't care that there's a bone poking through the... And there we go. We resume. It's Lungwe leading out front. Then it is...
That's Luca battling it out for second place, but he has got the drive now, and he's chasing down Luca as much as possible. Manages to get ahead of Roberts. Roberts tried diving him in turn one, and now onto a sure shot battle. You see Zadie Williams under a bit of pressure as well as he battles his way around. And you Robert right behind him, breathing down his neck once again. Robert not giving up as yet, and really is doing everything he can, trying to put as much pressure on Luca, having to go really defensive. But that Super Motard is really giving him a run for his money.
Yeah, again, what Robert is going to have to do is actually just try and get really close out of turn two. That little 390 in front of him is really quick though through those corners, carry a lot of speed, but he's got to get very close, try and get right up next to him, break as late as possible and just block past, and then try your utmost to stay ahead.
Bring up there between two Super Motards, so we'll try and get a camera angle on that.
That's Mike. I'm pretty sure that's Mike Grove. It looks like Mike Grove. He just pushed the other rider wide. Robert Gibbons, I think that is. Yeah, Robert Gibbon. I'm pretty sure that's Mike Grove pushing him wide. You remember Mike Grove stalled off the line in the first start.
Well, he's definitely on the charge now, trying to make up as much ground as possible. I see our flagman is out there from the Kyle Army Marshals, going to be showing that Lungu's got one lap left to go. And now it's a all full steam head charge. And let's see, Robert has to go and give a chase there, but Mike Grove really pushing a limit there, trying everything he can to make up as much ground as possible. You know, a bit of a dismal start for him, and you know, before the restart. And
I'm gonna make you mine.
that's a thing to tell you about the racing community.
Oh, we've got a bit of a ding-dong going here. Who is that? Number 60. I'm going to see where that is. That's a long way. It's a... Mike Grove crossed the line in fourth. Then we're going to see Robert Gibbon, and then the dice, which is between Zadie Williams and Brendan Parson. Zadie Williams taking the, well, taking. I mean, he's. I've always loved watching him ride. I mean, he, as I say, he's got that way of kind of dominating the bike. He was a little bit sort of when he first started. I mean, he was just unafraid of anything. He would get on that bike, head out of the pits, and just ride like his like his.
Much better. That was good. I enjoyed that. I finally got past him. I've just shoved him out. I was like, fuck you.
Get out of the way.
See if this light comes on, it's working. If it doesn't, light's on, working. So it's the warmers that are fun. It's fine. I don't need a rear tire.
Here we have 77. That's Savannah Woodward having a hard time now. 2 odd years ago, she was involved in a very big accident riding in the Ladies' Cup in Mexico, where she actually went to hospital. She was in a coma for a while. People weren't sure what was going to happen. And being the trooper she is, she managed to recover about a year of recovery. And now she is back on the bikes again, getting in her groove again. And yeah, once again, she's got a lot of supporters, a lot of family, and again, doing them proud.
Well, I can tell you one thing. When Savannah Woodward went down, the family asked for guys to lend a hand to try get her back to South Africa. Every South African rider and fan that's of South African racing said, listen, how can we help? They put money together and they got her back. I will be in the corner with the finest demon girl.